Hey folks, in this video, I'm going to teach you a bunch of tricks that will help you quickly purge your photos library of all sorts of junk. This includes duplicate photos, videos you accidentally took from your pocket, screenshots, thumbnails, and all those 2-second videos that you didn't mean to take because, oops, you thought your camera was in photo mode.
David, I need you.
So if you're running out of space on your devices, or frankly, if you just want to clean things up, then this is the video for you. Heads up, you will need your Mac for this class. Bye-bye, junk photos. That's coming up next on Tech Talk America. Hey folks, and welcome to the class. Before we begin, I want you to be able to see the before and after of what we're about to do, so do me a favor and write down the total number of photos and videos you currently have in your photos library. You will find that number at the very bottom of the list. When you're done following along, do the math and let me know in the comments section how much space you got back. In order to clean your photos library, we are going to use an app called Power Photos. I have a direct link to Power Photos in the video description, as well as a coupon code that'll save you 10%. Power Photos recently released version 2 of their software, which has several new features. And if you bought the first version, you can upgrade to version 2 for 50% off. Plus, you can still use my coupon code to save an additional 10%. One of the biggest changes in Power Photos 2 is that it is fully functional even if your photos library is set to optimized, whereas in version 1, you had to have all of your files downloaded locally. Many of the other new features you will end up seeing over the course of this video, so let's dive in. We're going to start by targeting duplicate photos. When you launch Power Photos, click this icon at the top to run an initial scan for duplicates. My recommendation is that you just use the default options when performing your first scan. Now, click Begin Duplicate Search. After a few minutes, it populates a list of all of my duplicate photos. It makes a recommendation for which one to keep and which ones to delete. If you want to manually change the selection, just click on it and tap the return key to change the status. When you're done, click Trash Duplicates. Please be aware, this process can take several minutes to complete. It might even look as if the application is frozen. Here is the reason why. Let's say, for example, Power Photos finds these 3 duplicate images. It's going to mark one as a keeper and the other 2 for deletion. But before it moves the other 2 images to the trash, Power Photos scans all of my albums to see if any of those images that are about to be deleted are referenced there. So let's say this photo is found in one of my albums. Power Photos will automatically take the keeper and move it into that album in order to keep that relationship intact. That's a feature that most people would never even think to prioritize, but it's a perfect example why the app is worth the price. The next type of junk files that we're gonna target are the largest files in your library. So if you're running low on space, you're gonna love this trick. One of the weird things about Apple Photos is that there is no way to sort everything by file size. And if you're like most people, the biggest file in your library is probably a video. And who knows, it might be one that you didn't even intentionally take. To find the largest files in your library, let's switch the view to list mode. Now, here in Media Types, let's click on Videos. At this point, we're going to secondary click into the menu bar and add size as a column. Next, let's sort by file size by double-clicking so the largest videos are at the top. You can use Quick Look to see what a video looks like without actually opening it. Just single-click on a file so that it's highlighted and then tap the space bar. If I tap the down arrow, the preview shifts to the next file. If you want to delete a file, you first need to close Quick Look by tapping the space bar again, then tap Command-Delete on your keyboard. Bye-bye, largest files.
I want to see motion, movement, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Now that we've found and removed the largest files in your library, let's talk about another type of junk file that doesn't take up a lot of space, but they're still annoying and they're still junk. We're talking about thumbnails. Just in case you're not familiar with the term, a thumbnail refers to a highly compressed image that is used as a preview file for a much larger image. And because they're so much smaller compared to the original, many times they don't get flagged as duplicates. One of the most common questions I get about thumbnails is how did they get there in the first place? In my experience, it's usually caused by a tech person who shouldn't be a tech person, also known as Best Buy.
Snap, David.
To find all of the thumbnails that are hiding in your library, let's secondary click once again in the toolbar and add dimensions as a column. Now let's sort by dimensions and go to the smallest images. These are a few examples of what thumbnails look like. Their dimensions will be somewhere around 320 by 240 pixels. To remove them, once again, just select them and then use Command Delete to send them to recently deleted. Bye-bye, thumbnails.
Could you tell me—
Bye-bye. I'm sorry, what? What part didn't you understand? The buh or the bye? Bye-bye.
The next type of junk files that we're gonna hunt down are those 2-second video clips that you didn't even mean to take because, frankly, you thought your camera was in photo mode. Let's click on videos here in media types and sort everything by size. All of the 2-second videos are gonna have a very small file size, so you'll see them all grouped together here at the top. Just like before, you can use Quick Look to verify that they are in fact accidental captures, and then use Command Delete to send them to recently deleted. Bye-bye, 2-second videos.
Yeah, knock, knock.
Who's there?
Bye-bye.
Another media type that can take up a significant amount of space are slow motion shots. Because these videos are filmed at a high frame rate, they tend to take up a good amount of space. Once again, the advantage of using Power Photos for this process is you can easily see how much space each file takes up and deal with them accordingly. For those of you who take a lot of screenshots, you might want to go here into the screenshots category and do a little spring cleaning. You can do that either from Power Photos or the built-in Photos app. And at this point, I want to take a quick moment to teach you a little trick that will dramatically decrease the size of screenshots that you capture in the future on your Mac. Check this out. By default, when you take a screenshot on a Mac, it is formatted as a PNG file. But if you type this code into Terminal and then tap the Enter key, it will switch it to JPEG in the future, which takes up a fraction of space. When I did this on my Mac and captured my desktop, the PNG version was just shy of 14 megabytes. When I switched it over to JPEG and took the same image, the size of the file dropped to 2.2 megabytes. For some reason, YouTube doesn't like it when I put terminal code in the video description, so instead, I'll put a link in the video description that goes to a page on my website, and I'll just put the code there. Like I said, just copy and paste it into terminal, and then tap the Enter key. The last category of junk photos that we have to talk about are similar photos. That's when you take 10 photos of something, hoping that one comes out. There is another app that does a decent job of finding similar photos, but because it requires so much explanation, I'm gonna save that tool for people who wanna work with me one-on-one.
You don't understand! We must find them so we can get rid of them!
So if you would ever like to book a one-hour session, visit my website at techtalkamerica.com. And for a limited time, you can save $50 off the normal price. If this video helped you, please consider clicking the new Super Thanks button. That allows you to leave a little tip of your choosing, even if it's as little as $2. Think of it as the digital equivalent of buying me a cup of coffee. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. This is David A. Cox with Tech Talk America. Class dismissed.
Let's move. Bye-bye. Let's pick this thing up. Let's go four at a time. One, two, three. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Thanks a lot.